Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another build. Today's build was actually decided by you guys about a month ago on my very first community poll. Lo and behold, here we are, many weeks later, and I do have, in fact, the Cozy Bookstore for you guys. This lot was designed in Windenburg, and it doubles as a bookstore, cafe, and a creative space for your Sims. So it's definitely a very interesting dynamic spot, and I really hope you guys enjoy it. So with that, let's head on over to the world of Windenburg and check out the build. Alright guys, and here we are with a full view of the lot. As mentioned, we are in fact in the world of Windenburg, and we're actually in this small 20 by 20 lot situated in the Plots District. I thought it was a really cool private area for this bookstore to be situated in. And as you guys can see, it is quite tall. It definitely has a lot of interesting spaces inside. You guys can see a look at the little cafe to the right side, followed by the bookstore on the left. When I was building this, I was going for mainly a more urban industrial style, so hopefully that does communicate. I definitely wanted it to look like it belonged in a city area. This is just a view of the Loft or Rooftop cafe, which is really cool. But zooming out, we will check out the lot in different forms of lighting. We'll switch it on over to the morning view, followed by the afternoon. Heading on over to the evening now. And finally back to the night, where we will take a look inside. Starting off our tour is of course the first floor, and we do have a combination of both the cafe and the bookstore to take a look at. But moving over here, this is of course the entrance to the cafe. I really wanted to have a very fun kind of like pop art, pastel, contemporary if you will, kind of like a mishmash of all those styles. And I really enjoyed using a lot of the objects from Snowy Escape. They definitely help to create that really fun vibe while sticking with the industrial feel of the room. And like I mentioned, this is the cafe, so we do have a lot of the objects from Get Together, particularly that big coffee espresso table, if you will. And of course, a nice large menu board for whatever your Sims want to order. We do have a small bathroom tucked away, so it is there for convenience, of course. But moving back, we also have a small kitchen area, just to fit with the theme of a coffee shop, if you will. Now, just as a quick note, this lot was designed to be a library, but it can also function as a retail lot, or it can also function as a cafe, just depending on how you want to incorporate it in your game. But moving out, we will head on over to the bookstore section, and this is just the main landing area here. I did have some benches originally, but you know, Sims, you guys, Sims are just not smart. They would grab books and then head outside and sit on the benches. So I had to relocate all of the sitting areas inside. This is just a view of the front desk area. And if you guys do want to use this as a retail lot, all of those stacked books that you see can actually be sold and bought by other Sims. So you will see them throughout this build just to add a little bit of versatility to the game. But yep, here is the main storefront area. We have a lot of sales signs, lots of bookcases. You know this is a bookstore, of course. And then we do have a sort of... oh, I don't know the word, you guys. But it's kind of sunken in. There's like a sunken in reading nook here, again, flanked by several bookcases. And of course, we have more debug books on the left. Moving on up to the second floor now, we do have a lot more interesting places in store. And moving over here, we're now on the second floor of the cafe. So there is no more cafe space. We do have instead what I would like to call a creative studio spot. So this is kind of an extension of what would be a basic library in The Sims. So you do have a nice sitting area towards the front, but then you do have an area for all of your computers. So I kind of set this up. I made these, I guess they would be shoji screens, kind of situating all of your Sims there, giving them some privacy. And there are a lot of beautiful computers. They look like iMacs if they were in the real life world, of course. And there's plenty of art from the Snowy Escape pack and the City Living pack on the walls there as well. Now, as promised, there is an actual art studio, and I wanted to put this section way in the front so all of your Sims have a really great view outside. We do have tarps to protect from the paint, we have aprons, we have gestural drawings on the wall, and for some odd reason, every time I was in an art classroom, there would always be a stack of metal chairs. I don't know why, you guys, but it's just a thing, so I did want to include that as a really funny detail. Of course, over here is a brush washing station, just again for more realism's sake, more just fitting with the vibe, fitting with the room itself. And heading on over here, this is of course the second floor of the bookstore itself. This area is an outdoor reading nook, which was really cozy. I loved a lot of those stone lights that came with city living. But then moving on in here is again another reading nook. This is kind of a loft view, so you can kind of see the front desk down there. We do have plenty of areas to kind of get cozy, chill out by those funky lanterns and funky pipe lighting, and settle into a good book, or perhaps play a round of chess. Whatever tickles your fancy, as they say. Ending off the floor is, of course, another landing area, and this pretty much marks the end of the retail space of the bookstore. We do have more debug books here, if you guys want to run this as a retail spot, and plenty of books on clearance. You know, we all love a good sale, and I'm sure your Sims will love that as well. Finishing off our build today is, of course, the third floor of the bookstore. And zooming on in, this is just a view of the staircase leading up. And as you guys can see, I did sneak in a teeny tiny bathroom there, just so you don't have Sims having to run up and down all those stairs. And of course, moving on in, we have a look at the full living room space. This is definitely the largest reading nook in the bookstore itself, but I really did want to include that really sleek contemporary fireplace. Great place to get cozy, get warm, and snuggle up with a good book. And I do believe there is a chess table in the corner there as well. Swinging it back around, I kind of lied, you guys. We do have more books up here, more books on sale, maybe some last chance books, maybe they're on clearance. Who knows, but they are there for your shopping needs as well. Heading on out, you guys did get a sneak peek at the Rooftop Cafe here. And again, it's a really fun, cozy spot. It is in plein air, so we do have some beautiful string lights. We have the espresso bar for your Sims as well. And you know, if you wanna practice some comedy, you wanna get some karaoke in for the night, this is also a really beautiful place to entertain with that super gorgeous view of Windenburg in the background as well. So looking at the lot specs as a whole, this is in fact a 20 by 20 lot. So it's super, super small. It can definitely fit into a lot of worlds if you wanna use it in Windenburg, maybe San Myshuno, or another Sims 4 city. Now the lot type is of course set to library, but like I mentioned in the video, you can also operate this as a retail store. You can use those debug items, particularly the debug item books if you want to set those for sale. And alternatively, you can also use this as a cafe, making use of those espresso bars. In terms of packs, we use 4 packs this time. So we do stick with our limit. We obviously incorporate base game, but we also have content from Get to Work, Get Together, City Living, and the Snowy Escape Pack. All right, guys, and that is a wrap on the Plots Bookstore and Cafe. As always, you know I love hearing all of your thoughts and feedback in the comments, and especially if you did in fact vote for the bookstore in that poll, I really do hope you guys enjoy using this lot in your world. Now, definitely stay tuned. My community tab is open and we will do another poll for the month of December. So you guys can definitely vote on my next build for the month. And I can't wait to see what you guys select. And with that, this has been TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.